Hi everybody, اليوم عندنا a special guest. احنا والتيم فكرنا انه كل مرة عمر يقعد interviews others, فقلنا لا دورك انت تكون on the spotlight اليوم. So, حابين نعرف عنك انت شخصيا, رحلتك في سكيبيدو كيف بدأت, ايش التحديات اللي واجهتك, ايش بتواجه حاليا.
طب حبه
كل هذه الامور
أيوة.
هندخلها حبه
ايوه حبه بس قبل ما نبدا and before we start انا لبست هذا يعني كويتش, رحنا فرح في الهند مره ولبست هذه الجزمه.
عمر هذا شبشب هندي ما هو كويتش.
يعني ايوه شبشب بس والله مريح. So anyway sorry.
بس هو الفرح ترى كان هندي ما هو فرح عادي,
بس
عشان
حلو.
نوضح يعني للمشاهدين
كان حلو. anyway so ما هو سؤالك الأول؟
سؤالي الأول هو كلمنا عن نفسك, إيش هي بداية انطلاقة سكيبيدو؟
بداية انطلاقة سكيبيدو, فإحنا عملنا انترو فيديو بس that was a while back. إذا ما شفتو it's probably the first video في ال دوما. بداية سكيبيدو كانت إحنا لما كنا عايشين في أمريكا ولسه between هنا وهناك, لقيت إنه الشباب سراج وزيد وياسمين وأنا included وشوية يعني yes وهبة, كلنا كنا مغمورين very involved in our phones. ديجيتال كونتنت يعني مره كثير, يوتيوب, امازون, انستغرام, فيسبوك, دحين تيك توك واند اند اند اند, والاولاد نفس الشيء. فصار كل واحد يعني اوبسي في مضر كثير للامور هذه, تبي مغمور في شيء زي كذا all the time. وغير كذا انه يعني احنا كعائله everyone had their own thing going on in their mini كذا silo life. و I was a bit concerned, فقلت لنفسي إنه ليه ما أنا أحاول إنه أسوي ألعاب that are fun, أستخدم فيها or I use household items أو ألعاب and toys to create games للأولاد وليا نلعب فيها مع بعض, and هذه كانت نقطة البداية. وشوية شوية طبعاً الأولاد الألعاب كانت في البداية ما هي مرة رهيبة,
بالعكس صراحة كانت مرة حلوة.
أيوة بس يعني قصدي إنه هم الأولاد يعني they give you feedback, the kids always give you honest feedback.
صح.
على طول يعني لو ما عجبهم بيلك بابا.
بس أتذكر فقلت. كانت في واحدة منهم كده يحط كده عواميد وكتب وأشياء ويحاول يعمل كده شيء عالي وخلاني أنط.
هذه
كانت يعني قاسية شوية بس كانت حلوة صراحة.
ايوه هقول لكم على هذه التالي بعد سكيم. anyway so هذه كانت نقطة البداية, وشوية شوية احنا والانا والاولاد we started doing more and more and more of these games, و obviously هم their input was the best لانه we know what they like and what they don't, فصرنا little bit more involved و more and more and more involved together, وشوية شوية بدأنا يعني نقلل من ال digital content هذا. Obviously we cannot ما نقدر نمحيه, it's part of our life whether we like it or not, or there is some positives to it obviously.
But too
much of it is not good. فهذا الشيء ساعدني أنا وهبة and the boys and ياسمينة kind of become a little bit more يعني مع بعض through these games and يعني شوية شوية صارت a way of life. يعني عارف لما مو لما الواحد يسوي ريجيم زي الكيتو اللي أنا عليه دحينة I don't know if I can sustain this on the long term, بس كانت الفكرة إنه Skipydoo أو تكوين الألعاب وحتى لو هم لعبوا بنفسهم يعني without me but at least they're doing something towards that and not digital is a way of life and it takes a part of their life. I think that was the main goal. Sorry طولت الجواب.
لا بالعكس حلو انه الواحد يسمع من الـ من الفاوندر صراحه.
والله كوفاوندر
اشياء ايوه معي. يعني اعتبر كوفاوندر شويه تصوير هنا وهناك شويه اشياء هنا وهناك
والفيلانثروبي والسوشيال
شويه اختراع بعض الالعاب هنا وهناك أيوة. شويه فيديوز وصور والتقاطات كذا لقطات
ورش بالبيبسي علي in the last game سودا باونس if you haven't watched it check it out
هذه كانت ممتعه الحق
ايوه
It feeds a part of me sometimes انه كده يكون في رش واشياء جربوها مع زواجكم
والاولاد
والاولاد ايوه yeah. بس لبسوهم نظارات عشان بس عينهم لا تتحرك في ناس كثير يسالوا عن انه موضوع السوشيال ميديا وانه كيف الاولاد يكونوا exposed وانه قد ايش من وقتهم بياخذ وزي كده فاحنا we wanted to clarify انه مع عمر انه يشرح اليوم عن هذا المقطع انه لازم الشيء هذا ما يكون يحسس الطفل انه هو جاب ما يحسس الطفل انه هو بيتحط قدام الناس بطريقه يعني هو ما يبغاها او يجبر عليها او شيء زي كده فاذا تلاحظوا في فيديوهات فيها سراج فيها زيد عمر انت يمكن تقدر تشرح اكثر
قصدك انه Skipydoo is not a job
No, يعني إنه كيف أنت you want it to be fun, engaging إنه الأولاد كمان ما يحسوا نفسهم إنهم بيشتغلوا إنه
yes,
هذا channel
yes, yes.
يكون للأطفال إنه هو يعني أنت yeah. بتشغل أطفالك.
Yeah, yeah. So هذه مرة مهمة نقطة مرة مهمة and يعني ليها a lot of angles. بس for me personally كيف الواحد يطالع عليها we have some ground rules وهذه أنا والعيال we came up with. If it's not fun, we don't do it. We stop. If it becomes too tiresome or boring, we don't do it. We do either something else or we continue the next day. So there always have to be fun. I always keep asking them, and they give me feedback and I give them feedback. So it's never a job. That's not the intention whatsoever. The intention is we have fun together. We have fun creating these games. And for them, هم بيستفيدوا نوعا ما in and kind of getting out that creativity
yes,
being comfortable speaking being comfortable being expressive even if it's in front of a camera right at some point absolutely. In your life حتكون you're going to go to classes you're going to go maybe in your job as an entrepreneur you're going to speak in front of crowds
طبعا.
Right so you're going to have to be expressive you're going to have to be bold you're going to have to be shuja' and this is just kind of getting them in the mold so to speak, and being very comfortable. So they, يعني for me and them, it's not a job, it's not a muhimma. It is something we enjoy doing, and then we share it with everyone, with the world. طبعاً, the long-term idea is to hopefully create a platform where obviously we provide games, but also there is some UCG from other kids from around the world that also provide games.
Yes.
So everyone is enjoying from around the world. So you learn culture through play.
صح.
Right. This is the kind of the MVP, so to speak, well, the progression. But at the end of the day, we've learned a lot. There's a lot to come that we're going to share. There are some skill sets that الأولاد اكتسبوها through this platform, from creating it to doing it, camera work, مثلا, or how to use a camera, speaking. في واحدة بس ما طلعناها
how
لسه
how to utilize things in the house
how to be play. Creative, resourceful
yes, absolutely
right?
اليوم by the way سراج قال انه هو يبغى بوكس وما لقى بوكس البوكس اللي لقى البوتم حق واحدة من الايباد حقت الدراسة حقته وبعدين لقى بوكس تاني كان حقت صحون
So he put them together.
فعشان ما كفى الحجم واحد مربع واحد مستطيل قص واحدة فيهم عشان تكفي الثانية وعملها بوكس.
Yeah.
فصار صرت أحسه يفكر أكثر إنه هو كيف يقدر make things work.
يعني طبعاً.
It's not sticking into one thing. It's building.
Broadening
it's
the.
It's building something in them. ما شاء الله إنه صايرين يحبوا يكونوا يحبوا يبتكروا يحبوا يشوفوا كيف أنا ممكن أخلي شيء يصير حتى لو هو ما يصير.
Yeah.
زي ما ذكرنا آخر مرة اللعبة حقت البسة صارت زي الباسكت بول يرموا
هذه لسه ما سوينا
الألمنيوم على بيت البسة إنه هو الباسكت نفسه يحبوا هم مرة يحبوا الباسكت بول ما شاء الله which is great
So احنا احنا يعني لم when we went وعشنا outside the thing that يعني I learned very quickly is كثير من الناس they want to build things and it's always harder to build things because you're going against the grain
صح.
right منك, you don't know what will work and what won't right and a lot of people say ah, why هذا قيد وهنا so why do it but if there is I think a real purpose beyond yourself طبعا if money is the motivation then forget it but if the real essence is you know I want to do something that is higher than myself
impactful
that is impactful for others using the skill sets that I probably possess not me but any person that you possess right that will give you always a dafa' and it's not being stubborn though you have to be you have to yani sometimes be driven by data right you have to be driven by feedback you have to be driven what the market needs but you have to also try to stick not stick but you have to also try to implement what you have in your mind and you're tweaking it so. Right you're adjusting فيليها in the startup world فيليها كpivoting yeah, right you have to pivot yeah. all the time you have to be flexible
حب الكلمة
right pivot
pivot
so that is always there so إحنا we want to always try to نبني we want to build stuff right and we don't want to always be consumers right you consume a little and you build a little right and this is the kind of the ethos so to speak.
يعجبني لما المدارس دحين بياخذوا اونلاين فالاستاذ طلب منهم يلبسوا كوستيوم وقال لهم ممنوع تشتروا كوستيوم لازم تعملوا الكوستيوم باي شيء موجود في البيت تخترعوا فالحمد لله انه بدا هذا الاتجاه يبدا في مدارسنا هنا يعني just very recent يعني الحمد لله انه at least
بس احنا دوبنا رجعنا so probably it's been there a little bit
I'm not sure
we don't know
it wasn't there at our time دائما الاشياء كانت البسوا كوستيوم اشتروا كوستيوم سووا كوستيوم ما كان عمره انه احد يقول لنا انه ابتكروا اعملوا سووا صراحه كان دائما الموضوع لا you know just get a costume and just wear it now no you have to use materials from your house either a glass or glasses or يعني an outfit or يعني you do it either mend it make it create it whatever
يعني أنا أتذكر
yeah. بشيء يكون عندك في البيت ما تشتري
طبعا هذه لا يعني if someone's watching if you're of age then you would get it but any kid please don't try this at home لما كنت صغير كيف الواحد ما في السعودية ما كان في نوبيلات slingshot How would I build a slingshot? I remember I had someone that very dear to me passed away, غلام, كان معايا for more than 25 years. المهم, فأنا كنت صغير, probably like 10. قلت له, I want to do a slingshot. And طبعا في جدة ما كان في, we didn't have any slingshot. He taught me how to build a slingshot. تروح to a tree that's شوية solid, and it has to be like a V. Right? It won't be a perfect shape,
branch.
But yeah, a branch. But yeah, يعني, exactly. but it's solid enough. And ish, you break it off, right? Which way it, يعني, you make it smooth, but it never have a good shape. It won't be a VV. It will be كده ولا كده.
It's not molded.
It's not molded exactly. So the next thing is I need the string. If you want a real solid string, كنا نروح للكفرات اللي هي الخربانة أو كنا نروح للبنشرية الكفرات ما عندهم هي وكنا نجيبها وكنا نقص أو يعني كده with a knife take out شوية من الكفرات and we lean it a bit so it becomes like a هذا and that's really powerful and it's hard to pull back but it gives a
it goes way back
oh yeah it goes and then you need اللي هي where you put الحجرة أو you put الورقة whatever ورقة ما تنفع but something else You needed that pouch at the end. فا we went and we got an old shoe وجبنا اللي هي اللي في النص هذه والله ما أعرف اسمها جلد and we cut it out of an old shoe and we put the
sole, the insole. The,
no, not the sole.
The insole.
لا اللي هي مثلا هذه الحتة.
The front side
okay. of هذا أخذناها and we put it sideways and we had a slingshot. So that's just in a way, يعني, my experience of being resourceful way back then.
إحنا I remember in Turkey كان مرة موضة إنك تشوت حبوب الحمص الناشفة كان اسمها لبلبي في تركيا يعني it's a Turkish word كنا نحطها جوة ال هي مو الستروكت ما تكفي مرة، فكنا ما أعرف كان عندنا بعض الأشياء اللي تكون نلاقيها في البيت زي إيش يسموها it's a hollow كده زي الستراو
أيوه.
بس أعرض شوية، وكنا ناخدها ونشوت بيها، يعني لازم تنفخ بأقوى ما عندك طبعا وحالة حسب قوة نفسك لسعة تلسع. كانت رهيبة هذه اللعبة. It's true. يعني we did have our moments.
Yeah, when we were of course kids. You did. You have to
بس
be.
بس دحين صار كل شيء مصنع وجاهز و...
now you
وأسهل مثلا... إنك تستهلك من إنك تخترع.
يعني anything. للأسف. Yeah. يعني مثلاً ضاع حاجة Amazon, especially in the States. Amazon يجيك يعني Amazon كأنه جارك. يعني عارف تروح. What do you need? I need a screwdriver. Okay, tomorrow. But if you order within 2 minutes, تجيك بعد ساعتين. Press the button, right? وبس وتلاقي الكريدت كارد شغال.
It's so tempting.
So يعني it is. شوف, it is become convenient. You do save a lot of time, but I think إنه for us, for me especially, يعني it is important that the kids do have these kind of this setting. إنه okay, let's يعني we don't have it, but we can do something and we can play a game out of nothing, right?
You know what's a great thing that maybe we can instill in kids as well? And when something يخرب, you don't need to just go and buy a new one. You can mend it.
Yes.
للأسف هذا ساير شيء مثلاً الشوز خرب خلاص أو بشوز جديدة. طب أوكي يمكن يتلصق من تحت, يمكن يتحط له شيء. أوكي بلاش الشوز, يمكن الشوز شوية صعبة. لأنه they
wear it. Oh, you can use the shoes in different parts.
Very fast. بس ممكن مثلاً اتشقت البلوزة. طب نخيطها معلي يا ماما, مو لازم تترمي في الزبالة. طب مثلاً الصغير علي ما أدري إيه, طب فيه ممكن يتوسع شوية. لأنه أنا بتكلم من ناحية السوشيال, إنه كمية الأشياء اللي بنشتريها بتضر الطبيعة وبتضرنا إحنا كبشر بطريقة مرة كبيرة إحنا مو ملاحظينها, وإذا إحنا ما وعينا أولادنا على هذا الشيء حيكون للأسف يعني الدنيا حتخلص مرة أبدر, حيكون ما في ريسورسز, حنضطر نروح نعيش في حتة تانية, نطلع على كوكب تاني. الاستهلاك وعدم التفكير, يعني مثلا قوارير الموية, انا اتذكر في امريكا دحين لما كنا دحين رجعنا للاسف الشديد لما رجعنا هنا ما اعرف كم قارورة موية بنشرب نستهلك في اليوم وكلها بلاستيك. اوكي انا ماني مسؤولة عن اني ارميها في الزبالة, لاني في امريكا كنت اشوف قد ايش كمية القوارير اللي بتترمي. اشترينا بيوريفاير وصرنا نشتري. اوكي اي انفست ان ا نايس بوتل اللي هي تقفلها وتكون يعني تتحمل حراره وبروده وخلاص, يعني واحده مثلا للكوفي واحده للمويه وخلاص, واعرف انه هذه حقتي واكون مسؤوله عنها ولما اخرج ما اضيعها. وللاولاد نفس الشيء, حطها في الشنطه دائما. كميه الزباله اللي خفت اللي بتترمي كانت مهوله. كميه البلاستيك اللي بتترمي كل يوم, الاغطيه هذه اللي بتترمي كل يوم, شيء مو معقول. يعني هذا كله لازم نعلمه لأولادنا, يعني حبة حبة هذا كله. أبغى شوية شوية ممكن نعمل تشالنجز, ممكن يعني تكون
حبة حبة على المستخبي.
يعني ممكن حبة حبة شوية كده ندخلها إيش in a nice way بgames بchallenges بشيء عشان يبدأوا يعرفوا قد إيش في ضرر على البيئة.
I think that is the part of the game.
ممكن أحط أخلي عمر يحط لكم لينك, عمر نحط على سكيبيدو لينك إنه أنت تعرف قد إيش استهلاكك.
شو
استهلاكك للأشياء قد إيش؟ يعني أنا حقي
استهلاكه ميتر.
أيوة أنا في أمريكا سويت الاختبار طلع تقريب كوكبين ونص.
يا لطيف.
يعني في صحباتي مثلا كوكب ونص, في ناس 4 كواكب, في 3 كواكب, حسب كم بنزين تصرف, حسب قد إيش موية تصرف, حسب كم قارورة بلاستيك ترمي. هذه الأشياء كلها يحسب لك هي الهاوس هولد حقك كم الكهرباء تصرف, قد إيش كهرباء, هذا كله يحسب لك هو ويقول لك انت قد ايش بتصرف, يعني قد ايش you will last or how long will your الكوكب هذا will last for you او شيء زي كده. It's very interesting. So عمر back to you. انا معلش دخلت كده دائما
no, it's okay.
بدخل السوشيال في الموضوع.
Yes, it's part of it.
I wanted to ask you about your struggles
in
general as a dad.
As a dad.
Marrying between the work والأولاد والشغل وأنا. يعني أنا مو لازم على سكيبيدو, يعني ما هو شوية بس يعني you know between us and the kids and work and everything else.
I think I think every dad or parent has, there are similarities in the struggle. وفي أشياء تختلف من عائلة لعائلة. And obviously كلنا نقدر هذا الشيء. And I think the struggle is always, you know, how do you, how, what is that balance between work and going after your dreams? And you cannot drop your dreams. You have to work for them. You have to move. And it's يعني أنت you're a role model للكيدز and you have to go after it. But at the same time, are you consumed by it? I think that there's a balance between going after it and working hard and really putting in the effort, and at the same time having family time and downtime and enjoying with your kids and family and making sure that, you know, everyone is going in the right direction, they're going in the right direction, they're getting what they need, not only food and school and hada, but other skill sets that they need in life. And I think that is the fine balance that I don't think anyone has found it. Yeah. Some days you really go full on and you can't see the kids, but other days you try to balance it out. And I think that's my way of, sometimes it's one day, like I'm really out there, the next day I say, okay, I have to balance it out and so forth. So that is a big struggle. طبعاً the other struggle, okay, that I think we all deal with is not only social media, but the content that is out there. It's so easy, it's become so cheap to produce content, to put out content, whether it's good content or bad content, it's just content out there.
If you have an iPhone or an Android or you can shoot,
there's a film that's totally shot, يعني في فيلم كلها shot on, filmed on an iPhone or an Android. So يعني the quality of picturing there, they're not that expensive now, okay? They're in abundance, so on any platform you have it. So you're consumed by it. Now, يعني there is طبعا positives to technology. يعني right now بعد ربنا ما كان في technology like Zoom and whatever it is else, we couldn't live with this pandemic. صح. So there is a lot of positives to it. But again, do you abuse the abuse, and I including myself, of what is around us? I think that is a struggle as well for me.
حلو. I don't agree with you about not being able to go to school or study إذا كان في هذا. كنا إحنا حنقعد في البيت وندرسهم.
Yeah, obviously.
أو حنلاقي طريقة.
Yeah, no, I obviously, yeah, we would have found a way.
No giving up.
No, there was no giving up.
But إحنا البشر ما شاء الله نتكيف بسرعة.
Yeah. But I'm saying.
بس نتعود على الراحة بسرعة.
But for work.
Zoom أريح طبعاً.
For work it would have been, yeah, for work it would have been much more difficult.
طبعاً.
It would have been maybe a little bit more casualties في الموضوع. So I'm saying, you know, it would have been really more tough than it was what it is now.
أحب أن أكبر عشان كده ما I don't just agree وخلاص لازم شوية ناقد ندي عمر المعينة it's been a joy having you.
Thank you.
One last thing I would like to ask is about, tell us about emotions.
Ooh. Emotions.
على بلاطة.
What يعني what exactly do you want to know about emotions?
يعني every person deep down has كده mixed up emotions. He has his, you know, his ups and downs, his sorrows, his, you know, his happy moments, love and affection, the way they give love and affection, كل هذا. مثلا أتكلم مثلا عن هذه الناحية فيك. وبعدين your advice من ناحيتك انت كأب انه انت ايش شايف
right.
maybe fix or maybe give advice or yeah. what you feel that you should
so
do
as
better
a, so as a, طبعا growing up I wouldn't say I was emotionless, but I I struggled with emotion, let's just say that, and showing emotion or expressing emotion. I was obviously alhamdulillah the feedback I get is that I was a genuine person and you could see it through actions, but to say it, to show it extra to
other. You still are.
Yeah, that was difficult. And I think when the kids came, Siraj, Zaid and Yasmina, that kind of made my heart a bit more lenient, right? There was a little bit more emotions, because kids respond to emotions, right? You can't, if you are a rock, then خلاص, صنع ما ينفع. So, and I felt, you know, I would get a lot more with them along more if I showed these emotions. And it was naturally, obviously they're kids, so you really love them, so the emotions kind of are brought out. So that was my emotional.
You're still struggling.
Yeah, I do still struggle, but I'm much better. I promise, I am much better. Or the kids can tell you, I'm much better. So that's my part. And one more thing before we, or before, you know, it's up to you when you want to call the show off. But the one thing I would say about emotions is, in the old days when I was in taking my bachelor's degree, maybe you and even our parents and so forth, it was all about hard skills, right? In whatever genre you went, it was hard skills. Hard skills mean more like math and science, and business, or rigorous, technical skills. Now, when you go to school or you talk about, and leaders you talk about or anyone you talk about, what they talk about is about, obviously there's leadership, but there's talking about emotional intelligence.
Yes,
understanding absolutely. Emotions, right? How do you understand the emotions that are going through you, and how do you really understand the emotions that are going through the other person to really come to that a common denominator or common kind of ground to move forward and to really achieve things together as a team and as a unit. And that's not only for work. I think that is also in a family dynamic. Could be, right?
صح.
It's a little bit more difficult in a family dynamic because emotions run high. But
دحين it's also a trend in how to become a servant leader.
Servant leader, yes.
يعني كيف انت you can not only انه انت يعني انت دائما انك تبى تكون انت الليدر وتنظر وبس الكاريزماتيك ليدر وانه كل الناس ينظروا لك لا انت كيف تقدر you serve اللي حوالينك انهم هم كمان يطلعوا يسعدوا في السلم ويكونوا ليدرز ناجحين لانه في الاخر هم حيساندوك باللي هم يعطوك
a unit basically a unit or a team
وما يقدر واحد ليدر ينجح شيء لحاله لازم اللي معاه ينجحوا عشان يقوموا كلهم
صحيح.
مع بعض
صحيح.
And when that goes through to them, they give back.
Yes. You know,
they feel that they've been served and given, and that's what you do with your kids as well.
Yeah.
That's what you should do.
Yes.
You shouldn't always keep on pressing. يعني مثلاً لازم تسوي كده لازم تكون كده لازم لا ماما لو سويت كده حتصير هذا الشيء. خلي عندك مثلاً شعور بغيرك خلي عندك كده
yeah.
اللي حوالينك كمان يستفيد وأنت تفيد وتستفيد.
Yeah.
أخذ عطا.
Yes.
I think that's a nice word.
Give and take.
Okay. عمر إيش تحب إيش تحب عمر إنك
ما خلص.
تقول ككلمة أخيرة.
ها؟ كلمة أخيرة. So أول شيء النصيحة or to give advice about parenting or being a father is very hard. And I don't like doing it لأنه في dynamics مختلفة different dynamics في كل عيلة in every family every parent is going through different kind of phases every kid has their own personality and if different kind of phases so there's too much going on to give a blanket statement right but there is a common denominator the common denominator is play and enjoyment and happiness creativity there is a common thing that we can use يعني enhance skill sets to kind of enjoy and create stuff that's not there and really enjoy without buying super elaborate stuff to enjoy right that is one thing play always brings kids together and adults مثلا if you go to a playground kid doesn't know someone else they will make friends they will enjoy they will have fun and the common denominator is just enjoying and playing and running around and climbing that's just play
في مره وديت سراج على الممشى وهو صغير وتعرف على واحد ولد صغير بيلعب معاه قاعد يبكي نص ساعة عشان يبي يروح معهم في السيارة يروح بيتهم ودوبه قابل الولد
That's one thing مثلاً here ولا في أمريكا ولا anywhere if you go to the basketball court you pick up a pickup game and you're playing
yeah.
right and you're getting to know people so that is a common يعني هذا is a common denominator I think is finding your play finding your enjoyment and continuing doing this I think that is important and that is something that we should all find either with the kids or without them just understanding how to do that and keep doing that and the other thing is through play and through this enjoyment and creativity we can cross cultures right and to bring an understanding of the world together and being appreciative and respect other cultures ours and theirs احنا together through play Because play is the denominator. We will play. What type of games? What types of games do they play in Japan? What types of games do they play in, مثلا, Malaysia? what types of game they play in Australia, what types of, right? And then
يدخل فيها
and it could be a lot of things and it could be a common game.
وتنمي عقلهم ويشوفوا يعني يصير عندهم دراية بالعالم الخارجي مو بس في القوقعة اللي هم فيها.
So هذا الشيء اللي احنا
especially now with corona going on. Yeah.
So we are working towards trying to add value in this kind of space on a platform that we're working hard to provide, plus the social initiatives that you bring to the table in terms of art and other social activities that we believe in. Play and culture are big topics and important elements that I think are for kids and adults equally to try to enhance and add value to and give back, right? And give back to people or kids who don't have this these elements.
It's really pretty in no every single kid has مثلا his own play can be many things. It can be art, it can be cooking, it can be, you know,
this could be reading, could be chess,
it can be just running around and just, you know, playing catch
and doing
يعني every kid has بس يعني just giving them the option إنه guys ترى في كذا شيء سووا واحدة فيهم just don't just sit there and be on an iPad and watch others do stuff. يعني إحنا الهدف مو إنه أنت تتفرج على سكيبيدو وتشوف إيش الأولاد بيسووا ولا إيش بها. إحنا نبغى إنه أنت تلعب. يعني مرة انبسطوا لما جو أصحابهم that was the first time they met ولعبوا مع بعض كأنهم يعرفوا بعض من 10 سنين لأنه يعني you know it was just إنه whoa these kids play the basket challenge, we want to do the basket challenge. وصاروا هم يختاروا they wanted to play chip soccer. بعدين عمر يعني صورناهم وحطيناها and they kept calling us back and they wanted to, you know, schedule another day to play together
and Zaid
the
actually,
kids want them to come back. مرة انبسطوا
and Zaid said he wants a Skipydoo themed birthday party so with adults included playing the game. So Allah yastur ala that, but it should be fun.
No, it should be fun. No, alhamdulillah, we're happy. We're happy that the kids are happy. They're making new friends. They're learning about other cultures. They're speaking to people across the globe. بتعلم أشياء جديدة. إن شاء الله يعني.
And I hope إحنا. Yeah, I think I hope.
Inspirational.
Yeah. Inspirational.
And we're
yes.
open to having everybody.
Any feedback.
No, and also like if anybody wants their kids to participate, يتصلوا في بعض, يتكلموا, يتعرفوا. They don't have to be on camera if they don't want to. They
yeah.
can just do
it's
it.
Just,
you know?
It's just organic play. Yeah.
Yeah. Just.
If you have a game that you like, أنتوا تحبوه, and you think it'd be fun or كذا, share it with us.
Yeah.
We'd love to. We'd love to have it and we'd love to do it. Yes. Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, pleasure.
On Skipydoo.
And always a joy.
You'll see me soon, inshallah.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye.